you've heard of startups building computer chips, robots and social networks. One called Colossal has a very different goal. Bring the woolly mammoth back from extinction by 2027 using CRISPR, a revolutionary gene editing technology. Bringing extinct creatures back to life is the lifeblood of science fiction. At its most tantalizing, think Jurassic Park and its stable of dinosaurs. Advances in genetics, however, are making resurrecting lost animals a tangible prospect. Colossal aim to bring the woolly mammoth, which disappeared 4,000 years ago, back to life, imagining a future where the tusked Ice Age giant is restored to its natural habitat. The largest mammoths stood more than 10 feet at the shoulder and are believed to have weighed as much as 15 tons. Flush with a $15 million infusion of funding, Harvard University genetics professor George Church, known for his pioneering work in genome sequencing and gene splicing, hopes the company can usher in an era when mammoths walk the Arctic tundra again. To be sure, what's being proposed is actually a hybrid created using a gene editing tool known as CRISPR-Cas9 to splice bits of DNA recovered from frozen mammoth specimens into that of an Asian elephant, the mammoth's closest living relative. The resulting animal, known as a mammophant, would look, and presumably behave, much like a woolly mammoth. Church and others believe that resurrecting the mammoth would plug a hole in the ecosystem left by their decline about 10,000 years ago. Mammoths once scraped away layers of snow so that cold air could reach the soil and maintain the permafrost. After they disappeared, the accumulated snow, with its insulating properties, meant the permafrost began to warm, releasing greenhouse gases, Professor Church and others contend. Permafrost contains vast amounts of carbon from dead plant life that is locked away by the extremely cold temperatures. The amount of carbon in these frozen stores is estimated to be about twice as much as that currently in the atmosphere. If it thaws out, microbes will break down soil organic material to release carbon dioxide and methane into the atmosphere. They argue that returning mammoths, or at least hybrids that would fill the same ecological niche, to the Arctic could reverse that trend. Mammoths and other large herbivores of the Pleistocene continually crushed mosses and shrubs, uprooting trees and disturbing the landscape. In this way, they inadvertently acted as natural geoengineers, maintaining highly productive steppe landscapes full of grasses, herbs and no trees. Grass absorbs less sunlight than trees. This would cause the ground to absorb less heat and in turn keep the carbon pools and their greenhouse gases on ice for longer. But many scientists have doubts on it. They don't think that this will have any impact, any measurable impact, on the rate of climate change in the future. Let us hope best for these studies to bring back the mammoth and to fight against the climate change. But extinction of natural resources is currently irreversible, yet humans continue to drive an era of mass extinction that shows no sign of slowing. And de-extinction is not the only conservation strategy that seeks to undo otherwise irreversible losses. For example, rewilding involves reintroducing locally extinct species into an ecosystem it once inhabited. If we welcome these efforts, and we should, then we should also welcome novel strategies to restore lost species and damaged ecosystems.